So happy Halloween. I'm a little dressed up. I put little cat ears on to be, I don't know, like a headband and wear to class. I'm actually gonna be Scary Spice for Halloween, in case anyone cares. So I'm making this video just to kind of like update my products routine and stuff like that I do and use, especially for this upcoming winter. And then share some news for the spring semester. I will be studying in the south of France, so I'm going to talk a little bit about that and what I'm going to do with my hair for that. So I have my little like shower caboodle here with all my products, so I can show you them and everything. So I'll get started. For my shampoo, since my hair is still blonde and I don't buy, like none of my products here are actually for color treated hair, I still use this John Frieda Sheer Blonde Color Renew. And one, it's tone correcting, so it kind of keeps me from being like super orange, but I like this orangey color that I have now because it just kind of goes with the season. So it's to neutralize brassiness and restore blonde. And I thought when I, and I can show you, it's like purple. When I first got this, I thought it would dry my hair out. Like I thought it would just be so drying. And because I'm like really funny about shampoos, which I bet a lot of naturals are. But it makes my hair so soft. It's like I feel like even if you're not color treated, I would use this anyway. It's just so soft, and it does clarify really well. On days when I'm not shampooing, I do co-wash, and I don't have the bottle with me, but I use the Pantene Truly Natural Co-Wash. That will forever be a staple product. I use that forever. So I went back to a conditioner that I first started using when I went natural, and it is the Suave Professionals. So the first one that I ever used was the almond and shea butter, and I still live by that one. But I love this rosemary and mint one. It smells like rosemary and mint. It's perfect. I went back to using this because the rosemary and the mint are good for like cleaning your hair and stuff, and I wanted something to kind of like stimulate my scalp, kind of like a scalp treatment type of thing. So I use it for that. I have not deconditioned with it yet recently, but that would be something that I would do. So I still use that. Good slip, great for detangling. Recommend it. Another conditioner that I use and probably will continue to use, that's also really good with slip, is the Organix Brazilian Keratin Therapy. Don't be afraid to use this because it says ever straight at the top. It's really just to smooth your strands. So it doesn't make your hair straight or anything. It just smooths your hair strands or whatever. I love this. It smells like coconuts and shea butter. And it just smells really good. So it's made with coconut oil, keratin proteins, avocado oil, and cocoa butter. I love it. It makes your hair really soft, good slip and detangling. I don't deep condition with this. I actually have a moisturizing deep conditioner that I use, which is, I don't know how many people still use this line, but I do still use the Canachome, deep conditioner. I have this one, which is argan oil, and then I have an avocado one that I use. I kind of alternate. There's no like specific way that I alternate. It's just like whichever one I feel like using that day. So another conditioner. I have a lot of conditioners. That's probably my favorite product, conditioners. I still use my Avalon Organix B Complex conditioner, mainly because it's pH balanced. And with bleaching and dyeing my hair, I went through a time period where my hair was extremely porous and I didn't know what to do. So I just turned straight to this. It's made with 70% organic products. The first ingredient is aloe vera juice, and then the rest after that is water, and then olive oil, oat extract, like a bunch of things like that. It has a bunch of it. And it says it's fortified with biotin, saw palmetto, wheat protein, and vitamin E for an energized scalp and thicker, fuller hair. Do I think it has made my hair thicker? Yes, because especially this part down here, when I first bleached and dyed my hair, it was so thin. It was so thin and breaking. And like, it still kind of is, because you can see some of the gaps in it sometimes. But yes, this saved my hair. Saved my hair after bleaching it and everything. Another product that totally saved my hair, and I did some research on it first, but then I kind of just took a chance, and I was like, I need it. It's this Roux Porosity Corrector Anti-Aging Conditioner. It corrects porous and aged weakened hair, so it kind of reverses your hair back to normal porosity if it's really porous, or if you have like low porosity and like high porosity, it takes you back to normal. And yes, I believe that it actually does, because within like two uses, I noticed an immediate difference. Because you know when your hair is, well, I had high porosity, so when my hair was really porous, you can feel it. Like, that would be my number one tip with being natural. Like, really get to know your hair. Like, you're gonna wanna feel what it feels like when it's dry, or when it's styled and dry. Know what it feels like when it's wet. Like, know what feels normal to you, and that will help you determine whether you need protein or moisture or something to correct your porosity and things like that. So it says to leave this on for 30 seconds, like, and it immediately works in 30 seconds. This is what I do with all my conditioners. I will apply it and then do, like, what if I'm in the shower, like, do the rest that I have to do, like, wash my face, brush my teeth, shave, like, whatever. So I leave it on for, like, 3 minutes, probably. Not a bad idea or anything. And then I rinse with cold water. I rinse all of my conditioners with cold water. When I first get in the shower, I wet my hair with warm, hot-ish water, and then shampoo. And then I rinse my shampoo with cold water as well. So, and I mainly was doing the cold water thing because my hair was really porous, and it said that cold water, you know, like, lays down your cuticles better. So, oh, another kind of shampoo that I will always use, and I've mentioned this before in videos, it is my Dove Damage Therapy conditioner, I mean shampoo. I never use the conditioner, but I do live by the shampoo. Now, it does have sulfates in it, but it doesn't dry my hair out, and that's the reason why I live by this shampoo. Yeah, shampoo. It doesn't dry my hair out, never has, never will, in my opinion. I don't think it ever will. And it's meant for intense repair. So if your hair is super dry and dull and limp, and your ends are rough and frizzy and things like that, like, it really does help with that. It does smooth everything out really nice. What else do I have? Okay, I'll move to stylers. So I have this one styler that I really like. Sometimes, like, it really, really depends when I use it. So I mainly use this styler when I'm doing like first day hair. Like, if I just washed my hair and I want to put something moisturizing on it, I use this Creme Brûlée curl cream. Smells so good. It really smells like Creme Brûlée. If you've ever had it, it smells so good. And yeah, it's supposed to define your curls without giving it like the crunchy hard feeling, which it definitely does. It makes your hair really, really, really soft. One thing I don't like, and I used it last night on this hair, which I'll talk about in a minute, but it made it like, sometimes it feels like, you know, when you put, like silicones in your hair or something, and that's mainly, I think, the reason why this is giving me the problems that it is, because it does have silicones in it, I think. Um, or not. But for some reason, it's feeling weird. And I think actually what I said it was, I think it was the glycerin. I think my hair reacts funny to glycerin. But yeah, it feels like kind of like a film or something over top of it. Like, I don't know, it's just weird. It just does a weird thing to my hair. But I don't say don't try it. Like, it's worth a try. I think everything over here that I've mentioned is worth a try, regardless of anything bad I might have said about it. So, yes, it makes your hair very soft. I use it when I do perm rods, flexi rods sometimes for the first day hair. And this was, if you follow me on Instagram, my hair was straight for 2 weeks. This would be the second week, I think. I don't remember. I think this is the second week. And I wanted my hair to be curly for my Halloween costumes this weekend. So last night I just sprayed my straight hair with water and applied the creme brulee to it while it was wet, and I let it kind of relax and like revert a little bit, and it reverted a little. And yeah, then I just like twisted it up. I did flat twist, three sections, flat twist forward, then the middle section forward, and then the back down. And I got that technique from Naturalisi. Then the other styler that I have and I love and that I will continue to use, and I actually just started using it, Cantu Shea Butter Leave-In Conditioner Repair Cream. So I basically got it for my blonde hair because I was going through damage with my blonde hair, and because I had ended up like dyeing it on top of like the bleached hair. Like, I just was doing like a lot of craziness. And this revived my hair immediately. Like, when I first was dyeing and bleaching my hair, it wasn't, like, when I did twist outs and things, it wouldn't look like this for a long time. Like, I had to darken the color and like really, really, really baby it. Like, I would wear it in buns for a really long time, like deep conditioning it and things like that. So this really helped a lot. I still use my coconut oil. That's forever gonna be a thing. That's it. I don't think I have anything like out in my bathroom or anything like that. That's really it. That's all I use. So when I go abroad in the spring, I'll be leaving in January, and the place that I'm going, the temperature is pretty similar to what it is now, like where I live. Actually, it's a little bit warmer because I'll be in the south of France. So right now it's like around 70, and here in Pennsylvania it's like 55. So yeah, a lot warmer. So I'm going to take at most, or at least these things, and I don't think I'm going to take a shampoo. Actually, I am going to take a shampoo. I'm going to buy this Burt's Bees, like 90% natural shampoo or something. No sulfates or anything. So I'm going to use that. I'm going to take these two things, and that's it. When it comes to deep conditioning and get protein and things like that, I'm going to really try to commit to food. I'm going to really try to commit to all natural ingredients. Like, the place that I live is gonna be like a little village, so I won't be far from like a market, and I'm just gonna buy eggs and mayonnaise and things like that and use that. I'm gonna really try to commit to that. I guess that's it. That's all I wanted to say. This video is so long. I'm so sorry, but thanks for watching, and I will keep you up to date with things as best as I can. Thank you.